Alright. First off, let me explain a few things why it's been a while. Okay, so a few reasons are that I've been gone, I've been on trips, vacations, all that sort of stuff, and then every time I get the chance, my brother's always been on. So, and then other times, I've really never been able to have this chance. So, yeah, here we are.
It always does something to you the first time. Then you get used to it.
I'm not sure I want to get used to it. That's him.
Miroslav Korda?
Yeah?
Lieutenant Carter Blake, I'd like to ask you some questions.
Chase him down.
Or he's gonna get away.
Oh, this is at Wednesday, but I'm not gonna do it like that, though. Oh, shoot! I forgot how this game works.
Hey, watch it, man.
Sorry, man. Going on.
This time it looks like we got our origami killer.
Yeah, sorry it took so long. I was just busy. No, I didn't mean to get up. I'm gonna sit down. You never know, there could be someone over here. Nope. Inhaler. Now. Actually, yeah, you know what?
You said I could contact you if I remembered anything. Can I come in?
Sure. Let me take your coat. You want a drink?
Yes, glass of water, please.
Take a seat, I'll get it.
All right, I got the glass of water. Come here. Casting couch.
Thanks.
I guess we can sit down now.
I just remembered something. Maybe it's not important, but a letter arrived in the mail the morning Johnny disappeared.
A letter? What kind of letter?
It was addressed to Johnny's father. I don't know what was inside it, but he read it and then he left. That's the last time I saw him.
You think there's a connection between that letter and Johnny's death, is that it? Do you remember anything else about the letter?
Well, I don't know why, but I kept the envelope.
Not particular. Except the address.
The address?
It was typed with an old typewriter. Could be a lead, you never know. Well, thanks for your help, Lauren. I'll let you know if it leads to anything.
Wait, I can't just sit around and do nothing while you're out there looking for the man who killed my son. Ever since you came down, I've been thinking, and I want to come with you. Help you in your investigation.
There's nothing you can do to help, Lauren. It's not a good idea. Believe me.
If you won't let me help you, I'm keeping the envelope. It's all or nothing.
Listen, an investigation like this is dangerous. and I don't have time to play the bodyguard.
How many clues have you got, Mr. Shelby? This envelope. Maybe your only link to the killer. I understand. It was a stupid idea. Sorry for wasting your time.
No, don't leave.
You're really something special, Laura. I'll give you that.
I'm just a mother. A mother who wants to find out who killed her son. Are we partners?
Maybe you better stay in the car.
We're partners, remember? Wherever you go, I go. What are we doing here?
We come to see Gordy Kramer.
Kramer? Bigwood Tycoon from Kramer Construction?
No, just son.
You think maybe he's the origami killer?
For now, I just have a few questions that need answers.
Anything over here? Nope. I have a feeling he'd be upstairs. Excuse me, sir. I have a feeling that's Gordon Kramer right there. Here it's just haven't been busy, brother's been on and a bit I haven't been here at the house for a bit, so no thoughts.
Okay, gotta find Gordy Kramer. I haven't seen Laura for a while. Gotta see what she's up to.
Hi, I'd like to see Gordy.
Gordy hasn't seen anyone. Beat it.
Should have showed him a thing. Hello, miss. Have you seen Gordy?
Excuse me. I'm looking for Gordy.
I saw him going upstairs a while ago. I'd be surprised if he comes down again this evening.
Now, can I go back over there, maybe? No. Alright. Another way upstairs. Hello, sir. Hello. Alright, can't go that way.
Those two goons and me seeing Gordy don't mix. Gonna have to think of another way to get rid of them. Got to find a way to get them away from the stairs long enough for me to be able to slip past.
Oh, I think I don't know.
I'm at a dead end. Maybe I'll take a flyer on one of Lauren's ideas. I'm at a dead end. Maybe I'll take a flyer on one of Lauren's
ideas. Heard that.
Maybe bust a few heads. I'm not tempted. But not such a good idea. Too many goon-shaped reinforcements around here.
Ain't nobody to talk to. Can't talk to my friend.
My name is Scott Shelby. I'm a private detective. I'm investigating the case of the Eric Kramer. I'd like to ask you a few questions. To know exactly what happened to little Joseph Brown.
Beat it! You hear me? Get the hell out of here!
What do you want?
A witness saw little Joseph Brown get the back of your legs. That was the last time anybody ever saw him. Now, I know you've been arrested and interrogated until your father made a little phone call and the file was closed. I'd like to hear your version of the facts.
The kid was lost. I just offered to drive him home. The police arrived, I explained the misunderstanding, and I was released. End of story. Nothing to get excited about, right?
I don't know why, but your story just doesn't check out. You've given me the crap. Now, tell me something I can't believe.
Very well. I'm the origami killer. I get my victims into my car. I drown them in rainwater. Then dumped them on a wasteland with an origami figure in one hand and an orchid on the chest. I do that because I'm bored, Mr. Shelby. And it's a creative and entertaining way of having fun. Is that good enough for you? Or do you want more? This interview is over.
Get rid of this clown!
Oh, right, balls.
It's a dangerous game you're playing, Kramer.
Do you know who my father is? He only has to lift one finger and you won't wake up tomorrow morning. The one that should be afraid, Mr. Shelby. Not me.
I'm a big old tough guy.
Might be a trap. I'd better be careful. This is the old Pico power station. I thought it was abandoned. Now where am I supposed to go? There must be a clue or something. The origami figure was in the form of a butterfly. So, am I looking for a butterfly? There's got to be a way into the building. The main entrance is blocked up. There must be another entrance somewhere. You might be able to find an entrance if I go around the building. barbed wire. There must be a way through. Electrical condensers. Going by the sound of them, they're still active.
Where do I go then? Here, gotcha. Oh yeah, it's L1, sorry.
Broken glass, sharp as a razor. Impossible to go back. I'm gonna have to crawl through it slowly so I don't tear up my arms. Match flame. It indicates where the fresh air comes from. All I have to do is follow the wind.
Thank you.
a draft. There's a slight draft. If I could figure out where it's coming from, it could lead me to the exit.
Go left. Left. Oh my god.
I've got to get out of here. There's got to be a way out.
No! So frustrating. He won't go the right way, and so frustrating. I hate it. Oh my god, I hate it so much. Don't turn that way. Oh my god. What is wrong with you? Turn around and go. Gonna lose it. Don't go that way. There we go, finally. Oh, great. Hold on. My earphones. My earplugs are coming out. Headphones. Headfits. Don't go down head first. Okay, good. Oh, you're supposed to let go.
Have a good look at each one of those condensers. field of electric condensers. I've got to go through them to reach that butterfly. A butterfly. There's a butterfly over there. That's where I should go. Keep it together, Ethan. Come on. I must have lost a lot of blood. I can hardly stand up. Got to concentrate. The slightest wrong move and I'll...
That seems difficult, all right. This must be the right one because it's different. Oh no. Oh no, I got it wrong again. Whatever you do, I cannot die. I cannot die. I don't want to die. Alright. Gotta be serious.
I will not give up. I'm in this all the way to the bitter end if it saves my son. No way did I just make my... How did I make my way back over here? Are you serious, man? I gotta look where I'm going real quick. Hold on. Oh, I'm supposed to be going straight. Oh my god. I can't. It's
getting real difficult. All right. Getting closer.
Barely any strength left. There's no way I can take another electric shock.
I can't lose this. I have all my hands available. Come on. Don't do this. Not now. What was I pushing?
I'm done. Nobody can get through these condensers. What the hell was I thinking?
I pushed the X button. I didn't touch anything else. No. You get up right now, mister. I'm on my last life, I guarantee it. Sean, unless I can save him some other way.
Ethan, can you hear me? Oh my God, what happened to him?
Origami figures. What is he doing with them? Calm down, girl. There must be something I can do to help him. On your chest? I'm gonna have to get your clothes off to disinfect those wounds. Those are serious burns. I don't know if I can do anything for you. Arms look really bad. I need to disinfect your wounds. But I'll do what I can.
Don't just put your hand on it. Alright, disinfect.
Your wounds are disinfected.
Not his chest.
He's unconscious. Now I'll just have to wait. And hope he wakes up.
I've been better. Was I out for long?
About 3 hours.
Why the Guardian Angel Act? You don't even know me.
When I was a child, I was always the one who used to fix my brothers up when they'd been fighting with the other kids on the block. I suppose I like to play the guardian angel.
You said you were here because you're an insomniac?
I've been going through a bit of a tough patch the last few months. It's the kind of stuff you prefer to forget. I do what I can to live with it, but it's not easy. You seem to lead a dangerous life.
It's not the one I chose.
Mixed up with the mafia, owe someone money, something like that.
Listen, I'm truly grateful for your help, but for your own sake, I think it's better if you don't ask any questions.
Right. I'm gonna go.
Alright, good. I will neat all over.
Oh god,
that hurts. You're prepared to make a sacrifice to your son on 9/11 Twin Tower Street. Ooh, that's some lag.
I've got nothing to do with that business. I never killed nobody.
Oh, no. Then why did you run away when they came to question you?
I already told you I'm not to report to my parole officer. I didn't go back to prison. When I saw the cops, I just bolted. I wasn't thinking straight.
We checked out his statement. He has an alibi for at least 3 of the murders.
Fuck, that bastard was a perfect fit. Shit!
Someone's calling.
Ash? Okay. Sean Moss's mother's here. She'd like to speak with you.
It was a few months back. The middle of the night. It was pouring down. Ethan came home completely drenched at about 3. I asked him where he'd been. He spoke about...
Jesus Christ.
He said there was something.
7. Why? I'm begging you. Jesus. I'm the house Kelly Kimster. Boom. Incest to a shrink.
I'm sorry, I can't help you. Now I must ask you to leave. You need to cooperate.
I'm looking around.
I know you don't want to protect me. You know anything?
I'm just giving you some free advice, Doc.
You know what? It's been an hour, so what we're gonna do is we're gonna leave it here. See you guys in a minute.